Welcome to the team, everybody. Love to have you here. What's up, everybody? This morning we're going to be checking out the Sim 14 hog. We're in the same household, so we don't have to wear masks right next to each other. But the Sim 14 hog right here. This is from SimPole. We're gonna try it on some front. You can see the place behind me here. Condos at the beachfront, French panes, painted wood. And we're gonna check it out, see how it works. We've used it on solar panels, haven't really used it for residential, but we're gonna give it a shot and see what we can do. So we just gotta attach this to our regular heads. We got our SimPole Excalibur and our SimPole Shogun in effect today. And we'll get some footage of that and let you know what we think. So the question that I ask about any piece of equipment that we have, when it comes to what we do, provide professional window cleaning services to residential and commercial clients alike, I ask, well, what will this do for our customers? Well, if you see us using a brush like this, this all natural boar's hair, hog's hair, 14 inch water-fed brush, you know that this is a solid investment into our business. This is not an everyday brush for us, but when we pull it out, it means that we are going to be using it for extra agitation, extra scrubbing power, usually for things like solar panels, which tend to build up a nice thick layer of dirt and dust on them. There's ample water flow that comes through these. So if you are a potential customer of ours, or if you are looking to purchase window cleaning services, when you see a piece of equipment like this, you know that the company you're buying from has invested well into their business so that they can provide you with the best optimum service with the best optimum tools. That being said, I'm going to talk also to our window cleaning fans and friends about the technical aspects of this brush. Okay, so this is the SimHog 14 from SimPole. Phil Alexander sent this over to me as for free. So just to let you know, he wanted me to try it out, test it out. It is heavy. It probably will not be our everyday brush. It's too much weight for what we do and what we need. However, if there is a serious scrubbing application like solar panels or maybe some big higher commercial plate glass that hasn't been cleaned for a while, this will come into play. It has a ton of compact fibers, natural boar's hair fibers, and those grab extremely well and agitate, which agitation we all know is a major source of how we clean things. So with the right agitation, we got that. This came with Euro thread. We adapted the Gardiner square quick connect because our goosenecks have that adapter already on them, so we can just pop whatever brush off and back on. It comes with the four pencil jets already attached with, I believe these are 3/8 lines. You'd have to go online to window, or I'll post the website below to get the more details, or to ask Phil in the chat exactly what lines connect here. But it comes with a kind of a bulky amount of line attached to it, which I understand. It gets a lot of water flow through it if you've got a pump or you got a good filtration system that allows water to flow through it at high levels, which is great when you need it. It's a bit much when you don't. I think down the line, if I'm gonna use this more and more, I will probably take these off and attach an overhead fan rinse of some sort. There's several of them on the market. I really like fan jets when it comes to overall rinse because they just get everything that I need out of a rinsing system. But this comes with the pencil jets as is. And if you talk to Phil, he'll probably lead you in the right direction as far as what kind of adapters work well with it as too. But as a general review, it's definitely going to last. You can tell it's solid, and I think ash wood. It's like a baseball bat on top. The brushes are long, and bristles are long, and a lot of them, so it's going to last for quite a long time as long as you take care of it. So all in all, excellent quality, excellent durability, a bit heavy for everyday application for us. Also, if you have a lighter weight pole, you probably aren't going to want something like this. If you look online, some of the poles, especially the ultralight type poles, will tell you, a lot of the manufacturers will say don't use brushes over a certain size or weight, and they usually recommend their own brush, of course, that would match that pole. If you start using things that are too heavy or with too much leverage on a lighter weight pole, they will break. I've had them break, the lighter weight poles. The SimPoles, especially the Excalibur, will hold this one up, but this is a heavy brush for those lightweight poles. So keep that in mind if you only have lightweight poles. Talk to Phil if you got any questions about that, or any of your suppliers about the heavier brushes and the types of water-fed poles that you use. All right, this is a monster brush. Here's the Gardiner hybrid. I think they call it the 10-inch, might be the 12-inch. There's a square quick lock fitting there. And here's that other beast, all boar's hair. It's probably a 14-inch or 16-inch from Philip at SimPole. He sent that out to me to give it a try. I think it's probably a preference for solar panels, but any other application where you need a lot of agitation. But man, those are some long bristles. Probably some 3-inch bristles and thick. Comes with 4 pencil jets installed. And look at those connections. Oh man, it's a beast. Our lines come in at 5/16, but these are, looks like 3/8 lines here. So, some background noise. Anyway, we're just going to put the quick lock from Gardiner system on there so we can interchange it with our other brush heads and goosenecks as easily as possible. Gardiner square quick connect locks. Just make sure that you line it up the same way the gooseneck. So our goosenecks are set up with the quick release tab on the top. So when we put it on the head of the brush, whichever way the brush is set up for directions. So the way this is set up, we want to put it in place like so, so that the quick connect is on top and it lines up well with our goosenecks. Have it. Now we'll try it out on our goosenecks. I haven't used this one yet. We don't usually use pencil jets ourselves. We like fan jets for their coverage, and I have other videos on why we like the fan jets. But because this is such a beast,
and such deep bristles, I think the pencil jets will spray out a little bit better, and no rinse bar or anything on it. So we'll just try it like so and see how much fun we can have with this beast of a hog's hair brush from SimPole. Thanks, Alexander. Thanks, Phil. Phil Alexander. Thanks, Phil. Welcome to our van bulkhead. Here's our Gardiner hybrid. We got a valve control at the top, so we need to release that. And, oops, wrong one. Leave that in there. We'll just disconnect the T intersection there. Pull off the quick release, which on this one's a little tight. Ooh, made it. Anyway, these quick lock releases are awesome because with the swivel, because we can interchange heads when we need to. Something breaks or we want to try something different, like this gigantic hog's hair from SimPole. Phil Alexander at SimPole. Anyway, now we gotta weave this thing in here and make it work because it comes with a lot of tubing. Put that in place. All right, now how are we gonna feed this line? That's a good question. Actually, I think I'm gonna do one over, one under. Let's try that. Let's try one over, one under, see what happens. Through the middle. Disconnect that. Put that in there. Like so. Alright. Feed out some excess line here. Yeah. That's a lot of tubing. But, of course, I think we'll adjust as needed for the tubing situation. We always run our line on the outside of our pole so we can exchange the heads, but there is, we can feed more through it there. Plug it in. Still have our on-off valve, but that is a lot of tubing up there. Anyway, let's see what it looks like once we turn on the pump and see what kind of action we get out of it. Like the orange glow this morning. That's because California smoke, air quality, all the fires. This isn't my work shirt, by the way. We're not sponsored by O'Neill or anything. Anyway, so you hear the pump. Automatic shut off once the pressure gets filled up. 60 PSI pump out of my van with the four pencil jets. We're gonna try this on some windows and put it on a pole. That's too much out here like this. I don't like that for banging against stuff. So I wouldn't use this on a sensitive area, but that's my problem. I gotta figure out how I'm gonna adapt that. Maybe I'll just run the line straight through and have the control valve lower in the line. Anyway, let's see what we can get out of this thing. This is all SimPole related stuff. Got the Shogun here with, I gotta ask Phil what the name of this brush is, because it's a beast. But we ran the line completely on the outside. It doesn't go through the gooseneck or anything. And I'm at my own house, so no mask during COVID-19. And no professional shirt, so sorry about that.
this thing covers some ground, that's for sure. That's going to be heavy up high. But we're going to have some fun with it. See what we can do with it. Hog's hair, 14-inch with 2.5, 3-inch bristles, 4 pencil jets. Why not? It's thirsty, isn't it? It builds up a lot of pressure, you can hear it. Blast ready. Blast it. Power! Alright, let's have some fun.